The U.S. Treasury Department on Monday said it expects to be able to pay the U.S. government's bills only through June 1st without a debt limit increase, leaving a little over a week for White House negotiators and congressional Republicans to reach a deal. By failing to raise America's debt ceiling in time, Congress could drive the country into its first default in modern history. A collapse in stock markets and panic throughout the global economy are all within the realm of possibility. This could have serious implications for our tourism dollar, notes partner at Grant Thornton, Richard Peterkin.
60% of our tourism stayover arrivals come from the States. So if, in fact, investors in the States and so on are suffering because of the default, and we're getting a lot of the high-end type of tourists, they're not going to travel. They're going to stay home and soak up their losses and be careful with their money. And we've become dependent on that source of arrivals. We can't replace it by Caribbean or by UK. So it would mean our arrivals will start going back down during the rest of this year. Similarly, we've been having a lot of investment from the US for a change over the last couple of years on local products for projects such as Cabot, for example, where most of their buyers are from the US. And they're paying top dollar for real estate and whatnot. So again, that level of wealthy person is going to be so affected. The linkages with the currency. I mean, yes, EC dollar is linked to the US dollar. So as default, and the US dollar goes down, and that's good for tourism because people can come here cheaper. But it's bad for any debts that we have in US dollars and all the purchases that we may be making from Europe and China.
Prime Minister Philip Pierre during Monday's pre-cabinet briefing said the government is watching the situation and hopes the two sides can reach a deal.
What the GOP in the U.S. is doing, they've taken an extreme position. And as I was reading this morning on CNN, that could probably lead to a massive recession in the entire world. But that happens when you take extreme positions. I'm hoping that good sense can prevail. And if the U.S. defaults, in the U.S. defaults, the U.S. never suffers, The U.S. do things for them to survive. We are in these islands. We're the ones who are going to suffer. But we hope it doesn't happen.
Peterkin shares the view that the Republicans are playing a game of chicken in an effort to improve their chances in the 2024 U.S. elections.
It really has very little to do with, the way of running the country, because under Mr. Trump, they increased the debt ceiling 3 times without any negotiation. And Democrats allowed them to do that. So they're only doing this now. It's a small group of ultra-right conservative people. And it's not good for the world. And yet here we are waiting with bated breath to find out how that's going to affect us.
Peterkin says that while both sides of Congress would not really wish the country to default on its debt, there is no certainty how the situation will play out given the uncertain nature of politics. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.